Six sigma is a methodology to reduce the defects by reducing the variation, so that my product's performance on a particular feature, we call it CTQ, really improves. Do you understand the meaning of the definition? Six sigma is a methodology to reduce the defects by reducing the variation by improving my product's performance with respect to a particular CTQ, right? Critical to quality. And Six Sigma gives two methodology, DMAC and DMACB. However, our focus is now limited only to DMAC, right? We want to improve the quality of the existing product. There are certain failures right now happening. I wanted to reduce it. In order to understand the process capability or Sigma level, I'm bringing a very simple example. All of you know the food delivery company called Swiggy or Zomato?
Yes, sir.
Every day you have been using, right? We order everything that is required. We order through Swiggy and Zomato. And something is written on the Swiggy's, you know, the vehicle. That means they have declared 30 minutes delivery, otherwise food is free. 30 minutes delivery, otherwise food is free. In a particular area, that commitment has been made. If Swiggy commits such a commitment, makes such a commitment, what is the upper specification limit for delivering the food now?
30 minutes.
If the food is delivered beyond 30 minutes, you will not be able to bill your customer. Food has to be free, isn't it? Your business will lose. And now what could be the lower specification limit? What is the lower specification limit? Upper specification limit is 30 minutes, you said correctly. What is the lower specification limit?
Not defined, sir. It is as early as possible.
As early as possible. Beautiful answer. Very good. Sometimes people say zero, but zero cannot be considered as lower specification limit because food has to be prepared and then, you know, it comes to the delivery boy. So let us say the lower specification limit, you know, at the earliest, you can deliver food in 10 minutes, right? So LSL is 10, USL is 30. So what is your targeted delivery time? 20 minutes. Targeted delivery time is 20 minutes. Commitment is 30 minutes, but what are you targeting? You are targeting 20 minutes. You know why? If something goes wrong, that 10 minutes will save you. This is called tolerance, right? So 20 plus or minus 10 minutes is the specification. Now, what is the targeted delivery time?
20.
You are seeing here, targeted delivery time. What is the upper specification limit? 30 minutes. What is the lower specification limit?
10.
Minutes, right? If your business meets this requirement, if Swiggy can deliver all the food orders within 10 minutes and 30 minutes, they can bill for all the work they are doing. If it is beyond the USL, and they will lose the money, right? And this is called capability. I am visualizing this in the form of, you know, some lines. You see, the targeted delivery time is 20 minutes. USL is 30 minutes, LSL is 10 minutes. Now the difference between USL and LSL is called specification width. How much is the specification width? 20. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, you have been hired as a consultant. One of you asked about the job opportunity. And now I am creating a job opportunity, right? And Swiggy wants a person like you, an MBA, preferably with the skill set, to analyze what is happening in the business and then suggest some constructive improvement. If Swiggy hires you, why they hired you? Why they appointed you? Because their sales is going down. They incur a loss in a particular area. So you need to analyze what is the real performance, and then you need to suggest them some improvement ideas, thereby business can improve. Now tell me, what will you do if you are given such an opportunity, if a project opportunity is given to study how the business is going on for Swiggy in a particular pin code, what will you do first? Will you go behind each and every delivery boy? Come on, tell me. How will you study the business?
First, we have to identify the variables which can cause this delay in the delivery, sir, which is bringing out the market.
Very good. I agree. First of all, whether there is a problem or not, that you need to understand. If there is no problem, you don't have to do anything, isn't it? If everything is going fine, let it go. But if there is a problem, then only we will initiate a project. So in order to understand whether there is a problem or not, you need data. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So you collected sample in a particular pin code, a sample of 100 deliveries, or depending on your strength, you can take any number of samples. 1,000 also is okay. Let us say sample, random sample of 100 deliveries have been collected by you. With all 100 deliveries, you calculate the average. See, sample average and customer target are different. Customer target is 20 minutes. Customer target is denoted by the symbol mu. Sample average is generally denoted by the symbol x bar. You understand? Customer target is denoted by the symbol mu. Sample average is denoted by the symbol x bar. Imagine you collected the delivery time of 100 deliveries and the average is found to be 20 minutes. What is the targeted delivery time? 20 minutes. What is the sample average? That is also 20 minutes. What does it mean to you? It means to you the process is designed perfectly in line with the customer target.
Also performing in line.
Performing in line. The plan is getting properly implemented. So average 20 minutes means your average is on the target, but still some of the deliveries, your delivery boy are taking more than 20 minutes. Some deliveries, your delivery boys are completing before 20 minutes. So there is a variation, isn't it? In order to understand the amount of variation, you need to calculate standard deviation. See here, 100 data points you have. Using 100 data points, will you be able to calculate sigma? I need an yes.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So that sigma is calculated to be 3.33. How is it going to be helpful? Now, see, I have taken only sample of 100 deliveries. Can somebody tell me in one day how many deliveries Swiggy could make? How many deliveries Swiggy may make in one day?
Maybe around 500.
Can be any big number also.
In that pin code, I'm just...
Yeah, in that pin code only, I'm telling. In that pin code, definitely, no, there are, in a particular pin code, there are hundreds of delivery boys are there. If every delivery boy, let's say he makes, you know, 10 or 20 delivery, that itself will run into several thousands. And so in a month, let's say in a day, 1,000. So in a month, how many delivery?
30,000.
So in a year, how many delivery?
360,000
delivery. I want to understand the performance of Swiggy over the next 1 year. What will happen to the 360,000 deliveries when I run the company in the same fashion? Will I be able to comment on the population? Population is so big. All that I have is 100 data. I will calculate control limit, upper control limit, average plus 3 sigma. Sigma is 3.33. What is 3 sigma? 3 into 3.33 is how much?
9.99.
That's all. So 9.99 plus 20 is almost 30. Your upper control limit is 30. All right. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, lower control limit is 10. So upper control limit is 30. Lower control limit is 10. That means 99.73% of the deliveries by Swiggy are going to happen between 10 minutes and 30 minutes. Do you find my statement logical and, you know, proper? Do you understand my English now? 99.73% of the deliveries by Swiggy in that pin code are going to happen between 10 minutes and 30 minutes. How is this finding coming out? From the sample. So at this stage, I expect all of you to permit me to complete this topic before leaving today. Will you permit me? Because we only have 10 more minutes. I anticipate a delay. Is it okay to all of you? I anticipate an additional 10 minutes delay. Is it permissible? green bells here, you have to tell me. If I go up to 240, is it okay or not okay?
Yes, sir.
Oh, if there is a problem, you can tell me. If there is
sir, okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Because why I am asking, you know, by 2:30 I'm seeing many people going out of the meeting. Right? You have to stay till I complete. Fine. So now we understood this thing. These all these vertical bars, when you are, you know, when you construct, that is called the histogram. I will teach you tomorrow how to generate histogram, how to generate Pareto, how to conduct MSA, everything, you know, from Minitab effortlessly. So your job is going to be very, very easy, you know, if you properly understand. Now, in order to understand my process capability, I am going to compare where is my control limit with respect to the specification limit. Specification limit was 30 and 10. Am I correct? Control limits were also 30 and 10. I am happy to see my control limit overlapping with the specification limit. Why did I say happy to see? Because when my control limit just falls on the specification limit, I know 99.73% of my deliveries are going to be within 10 minutes and 30 minutes. That means I am going to generate a lot of revenue. What is the failure rate? Only 0.27. In order to understand, let me take a pen here. Let's say in a day, 1,000 deliveries are happening in the pin code. 1,000 deliveries are happening. Now tell me, how many deliveries are successful? How many deliveries are going to be successful? Can I say like this?
Yes, sir.
397 deliveries are accepted by the customer. Probably 3 deliveries might get rejected. Customer may cancel the order or may not make the payment. No, something, some consequences there. 997 out of 1,000 is a good delivery. How is Swiggy's business going on? Are you happy, really happy? Come on, tell me. Are you happy with the performance of Swiggy?
Yes, sir.
That looks, you should be happy because 997 out of 1,000 is really a great number. But there is one concern. Since the business is going well today, since your people are meeting the commitment properly. Rita, are you trying to say something? Okay, since the business is really going good, let us wait for 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Do you think the business will go up and up? Am I correct?
All processes naturally are likely to decline, like you had said.
Yeah, yeah. But since right now 99.73 is the success rate and many customers are happy, do you think a lot of referrals will start happening? Many people will recommend Swiggy and then many people will buy. The number of orders per day, 1,000, might increase to 2,000 very quickly, might increase to 3,000 very quickly, might increase to 4,000 very quickly. So when the demand for your product increases, or the duration increases, let's say 3 months, 6 months are over, there is a lot of scope for deterioration. Some of the delivery boy may not come to the job. Am I correct? Right? Some of the vehicles might become old. Your GPS system may not work. The packaging material may not be sufficient. Some consequence, some kind of variation and difficulties will be there. And then your performance is expected to deteriorate. If the performance deteriorates, two reasons. One is the variation, what I discussed. Another thing is, if the demand for your product increases, the success rate of 99.73, it is difficult to maintain. If you really wanted to maintain the same success rate, even with higher demand, then you have to do a lot of control measures. So whatever capability right now you are seeing, the 99.73% success rate, this is applicable only for the short term and not for the long term. You need to understand. When I say long term, it is either time or demand. If the time increases or demand increases, then you must consider long-term capability. The 99.73 can drop in a longer term. This capability, this process is right now called a just capable process. You know why do I call it just capable? My control limit overlap with the specification limit. my control limit overlap with the specification limit. When control limit overlap with the specification limit, at this point, can you tell me the distance between the process average and the specification limit? How much is this distance equal to? Can somebody?
3 sigma.
This distance is equal to 3 sigma. And so this process is called a 3 sigma process. The sigma level of the current process is 3 sigma. What is the kind of success rate it can give you? 99.73. How do I get the 99.73? From the property of normal distribution. But you need to understand this 99.73 is applicable only for short term and not for long term. Long term means either time increases or demand increases. All of you understand?
Yes, sir.
Very good. And I'm going to give a nickname to this process, because that will bring a lot more clarity. Look at the way the curve is looking like. Does this curve look like a head of the elephant? It looks like a head of the elephant, right?
Yes, sir.
So I'm going to call this process an elephant process. It is a nickname. I'm going to call this as an elephant process. Why I bring elephant here? Because all of you need to understand, though your sigma level is 3, though your success rate is 99.73, you are operating your business in such a way that you have put a big animal, elephant, in a small room, which is not giving any room for, you know, movement of the elephant. Do you see? Can you keep an elephant in a small room for a longer time? Not possible, isn't it? The elephant requires a bigger space, deserves a bigger space so that it can move around. Same way, if you keep your process, you know, with a smaller specification. See here, already control limit is touching the specification limit. If the process also deteriorates, like how the elephant wants some movement, your process also needs some movement in the long run. Am I right? Why? Because some days operator might change. Some days raw material quality will change. Sometimes the machine settings will change. Isn't it? All these changes will make your process to deteriorate. Is it logical? When the process deteriorates, what will happen to the control limit? Can somebody comment now? When the process is deteriorating, what will happen to the control limit? Control limit will go beyond the specification limit. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
As the control limit go beyond the specification limit, your rule of 99.73 will not be valid. 99 will come down to 90, 90 will come down to 80, and rejections will increase. So the 3 sigma capability is not good enough for a long term. So what is required is further improvement is required. If your expectation is long-term performance, if your expectation is short-term performance, it is okay. 3 sigma also gives you close to 100. But if your expectation is long-term, tell me what is required in your business, long-term success or short-term success? What is required?
Long-term.
You want to run your company forever. You want to see that next 5 years, your company produces no profit. No, so that you need a long-term performance. If you are looking at the long-term performance, again, look at the average and standard deviation. Your average is already on the target. No problem with average. Standard deviation was 3.33. I have improved the process. Improving the process simply means reduce the standard deviation. Standard deviation cannot reduce just like that in your sample. You have to work. You have to put a lot of effort. Probably you must train the delivery boys. You must provide them better GPS system, provide them better vehicle, provide them better packaging material. And they all will start working like a robot. Do you understand? Now the standard deviation can come down. Standard deviation of 3.33 now brought down to 1.66. What is the advantage? Calculate the 3 sigma. 3 sigma will be 1.66 into 3 is 5. Average is 20. 20 plus 5? 25 is your upper control limit. 15 is your lower control limit. But where is your specification limit? Still far away. 30 is the USL. 10 is the LSL. Now the advantage is, even if something goes wrong, even if your control limit moves out, still it is inside the specification limit. All of you able to understand the language? Sorry, understand the logic?
Yes, sir.
Even something goes wrong, right? Control limit is going, becoming wider, but still it is inside the specification limit. That means your success rate of 99.73 is now improved. It is definitely more than 99.73. It is definitely more than 99.73. Now look here. Specification width is how much? USL minus LSL, 20. What is your process width? Process width is nothing but UCL minus LCL. How much it is? 10. Your process width is only half of the specification width. So I'm going to call this process doubly capable. Doubly capable. A 3 sigma process has now become a 6 sigma process. You can see it here. Find out the difference, distance between specification limit and the process center. Can you tell me what is this distance I'm drawing here in the screen? How much is this distance equal to? Come on, please.
Total 6 sigma.
6 sigma. So this process is called 6 sigma process. 6 sigma capability will be more than 99.73. Because we have seen 3 sigma capability itself is 99.73. 6 sigma capability is 99.996. Please note, this is not long-term, this is long-term capability. Now imagine, Swiggy is delivering 1,000 deliveries every single day. Now how many deliveries will be successful? Tell me, what is 99.996 percentage of 1,000? This is almost 1,000. Can I say like that?
Yes, sir.
Almost all 1,000 deliveries are acceptable. Let's say the business 10 times improves. 1,000 becomes 10,000. Now what is 99.996 percentage of 10,000? That is also 10,000. Even if your business doubles and triples, your performance level is not getting affected. Abhagar, please mute them.
One second, I'm doing it.
Yeah. So
I'm doing it.
This is called a 6 sigma capability. Process is called a doubly capable. You need to understand you have converted your elephant into a giraffe. Why do I call it giraffe? My graph has now become narrower. When all my points come closer to the center, my graph will look narrower. Graph looking narrower is advantageous business. When all the point comes towards the center, your graph will not only become narrower, but also become taller. Only to make you remember this concept, I'm calling this process as giraffe process. All right. And now, just to check, tell me, look at my slide and tell me, is it looking like an elephant or a giraffe?
Elephant.
That means statistically, what is the sigma level?
3 sigma.
3 sigma. The sigma level is nothing but otherwise called as G score or Z score. You can ask RK, what is Z score? He can give a lecture for 30 minutes, right? So 3 sigma, Z score is 3. And what will be the success rate you can expect from a 3 sigma process?
99.73.
Is it a short-term success or a long-term success?
Short.
Very good. Very good. And now I improve the process. Improving the process means pushing the control limits towards the center. You have seen the control limit now running towards the center. When the control limit runs towards the center, now look at the process. Process has become narrower and taller. Is it still an elephant or a giraffe?
Giraffe.
Giraffe. Statistically, what is the sigma level?
6 sigma.
6 sigma. Now tell me, what is the success rate you can expect from the process?
99.996%.
Now tell me the 99.996%. Is it a short-term success or a long-term success?
Long-term.
Long-term success. Beautiful. Very good, right? So now, why do I call it long-term success? Actually, for a 6 sigma process, that score should be 6. But how much that score I have taken? 4.5. Always long-term sigma level will differ from the short-term sigma level by an amount equal to 1.5. Do you remember our discussion? So that 6 has been reduced to 4.5, and I have gone to the normal distribution table and picked up this probability. For a Z-score of 4.5, the probability of success is 99.996%. That is why I'm saying that the success rate is 99.996 for a 6 sigma process. As far as the Swiggy example is concerned, it is a one-tailed study. You know what is one-tailed? Only when the delivery goes beyond 30 minutes, it's a problem for Swiggy. Before 10 minutes is not a problem. Sometimes business may not have tolerance both sides. It may have tolerance only on one side. That time it is called one-tailed study. That time your probability will actually success rate will further improve. 99.999 has become 99.999% and 66%. It is under such situation the defects will be limited to 3.4 per million opportunity. Suppose if your study is two-tailed, it will be slightly reducing 99.9930 and then the DPMO will be double the amount. Do you now understand the meaning of 3.4? 3.4 is applicable for a Six Sigma process, applicable for a long-term result, and applicable for a one-tailed study only. So when your business data, process data has too much variation, it is hard to produce output within customer requirement. Under such situation, sigma level will be low, yield will be low, DPMO will be high. On the other hand, if you convert your process into narrower and taller like a giraffe, that means higher sigma level. Virtually everything you produce will meet the customer requirement. Absolutely, your products are defect-free and failure-free. That means sigma level will be in the order of 4.5 to 6. Yield will be very high. Defects will be very low. This creates a healthy scenario. Right? This is called Six Sigma way of problem solving. The real-time problem is converted into a statistical problem. And statistical problem is solved statistically. You know what is statistical problem? Standard deviation higher. Average not on the target. These are the two issues in any company. As a Six Sigma consultant, for me, every company is same. I will just look at the sigma. I will just look at the average. Average should be on the target and sigma should be as small as possible, right? And statistical solution can be arrived by physically, changing the process, right? That is called a practical solution. This approach can get you solution every time you follow the methodology correctly. If you want to follow other method, solution is rare. You see here, solution is rare, but failure is very frequent. But in Six Sigma methodology, success is sure, failure is rare. You can make your choice. And this can help any company improve the revenue. This approach can help the company reduce the cost, help the company improve the efficiency of the resources. Importantly, all the people who follow the methodology, practice it in their company, they will become very effective. If people are effective, organization will also become effective, right? And you can also be much more better than what you are capable of currently. If you really understand all these tools and use it in the solving real-time problem. So we learned certain things today, very, very important thing. The distribution is considered normal because it is symmetrical at the center. Mean will be equal to median and mode. And in standard normal distribution, mean will be zero, standard deviation will be one. Generally, mean will have certain value, standard deviation will have certain value. It is an imaginary thing. When you imagine mean to be zero and standard deviation to be one, then your normal distribution will be called standard normal distribution. In normal distribution as well as standard normal distribution, properties will be same. Within plus or minus one standard deviation from the average, 68.27% of the points will lie. Within plus or minus two standard deviation, 5.45% will lie. Within plus or minus three standard deviation, 99.73% of the data will lie. Sigma level is a measure of process capability. Higher sigma level means higher capability. Specification limits are provided to customer. However, control limits are calculated from the process data. A 3 sigma process is just capable in which the short-term yield is 99.73. A 6 sigma process is doubly capable in which the long-term yield is 99.9966%. 3.4 DPMO is applicable to a one-tailed test. And in a 3 sigma process, the control limit will overlap with the specification limit. In a 6 sigma process, control limit is pushed inside, right? Pushed inside. In higher the sigma level, higher will be the capability. For higher sigma level, sigma value must be lowered. What is sigma? Standard deviation. What is sigma level? It's your capability. In a 3 sigma process, control limit overlap with the specification limit. Process is just capable. Process just capable means CP equal to 1.
Short term.
Sigma process, the process is doubly capable. At that moment, we call it CP equal to 2. Because CP is the ratio of specification width divided by process width. If specification width is equal to process width, CP equal to 1. If specification width is double the process width, it will be 2. CP 2 means sigma level is 6. CP 1 means sigma level is 3. Subject to the condition, your process is centered properly. So that's it from me. So thank you very much for giving me that additional 10 minutes and as well as your patient listening. I'm sure you have understood the concept properly. If there are any questions you would like me to answer right now, I am okay with it.